Risk management should be your foremost priority as a trader. Finding a risk of ruin will help you develop strategies that suit your risk appetite. In this video, I will explain two methods to calculate your strategy's risk of ruin and how to use it to improve your trading. Risk of ruin is the probability that you will reduce your account to a level where trading cannot continue. This level is usually expressed as the maximum acceptable loss of your initial capital. As capital losses grow, the amount of profits required to break even grow exponentially. If you lose 10% of your capital, you need an 11% gain to break even. But if you lose 50%, you will need a 100% gain. If you are a new trader, I would suggest risking no more than 30% of your initial capital. With this method, you only need to know your win rate and the amount risk per trade. Risk of ruin can be calculated using this formula, where A is your winning percent minus your losing percent, and U is the maximum number of consecutive losses before you hit your ruin point. Here's an example. I've got a mean reversion strategy on the 5-minute pound Canadian with a 55% win rate. It uses a 30 pip stop loss and profit target with a $200 risk per trade. I start trading this strategy with a $10,000 account and decide to risk 30% of it. With the 55% win rate, A is equal to 0.1, and since I risk $200 per trade, it will take 15 trades to hit the ruin level, which gives me the value of U. Plugging in the values, this gives me a risk of ruin of 0.05%. Is this an acceptable risk of ruin? This depends on your risk appetite, but anything less than 0.5% would be preferable. This method looks simple enough, but there are two major limitations. It only works if your strategy has a win rate over 50%, and it assumes your wins and losses are the same size. If you are a mean reversion trader, you might get away with it. But if you're a trend follower, you probably have a strategy that looks something like this. The win rate is only 34%, but the average winner is almost 3 times the average loser. The equity curve looks promising, but we get a 100% risk of ruin. It is evident we need a more sophisticated formula that addresses these limitations. Let's use the equations developed by Ralph Vince in his book Portfolio Management Formulas. You will need your strategy's win rate, the average winner, and the average loser. The following calculations are not that friendly, so I have included a free spreadsheet that you can download in the description. Let's use the spreadsheet for the trend following strategy above. Like before, I have a $10,000 account and I decide to risk 30% of it. Then I look at my backtest report and input the win rate and the average winner and the average loser. The spreadsheet first calculates the average winner and loser as a fraction of your capital. Then it calculates Z, A, and P, and finally the risk of ruin, which comes to about 0.31%. With knowledge of your risk of ruin, you have an estimate of the amount of capital you may lose during trading. This helps you establish performance expectations. Using Vince's formula, here's the risk of ruin as a function of the percent of capital risk for the trend following strategy above. If you are only willing to risk 1% of your initial capital, there's an 83% chance you will hit that level. This is to be expected, since the outcome of any one trade is almost random. You may suffer a losing streak no matter how profitable your strategy is. If you decide to risk 10% instead, the risk of ruin drops to 15%. If you indeed suffer a 10% capital loss in actual trading, you won't freak out because 15% is quite a sizable possibility. However, it's extremely unlikely to suffer a 40% loss of capital. It would be prudent to deactivate your strategy in this case, at least temporarily. Note that the risk of ruin only estimates the probability of losing a certain amount of capital. It does not tell you when this will occur. Regardless, establishing your performance expectations beforehand will save you a lot of anxiety and indecision in real time. You can also use your risk of ruin to tailor your position sizing. The previous chart above assumes a fixed 0.1 lots per trade. If you decide to increase your position sizing, both your average winner and average loser will increase. Here's how the chart changes for 0.2 and 0.3 lots. As you may expect, there's a significant increase in risk of ruin as your position sizing becomes more aggressive. If you're only willing to risk 30% of your initial capital and want a risk of ruin below 1%, you should be trading about 0.1 lots in this case. So to conclude, the Risk of Ruin is a great tool to help you keep your trading within your risk appetite. You can download the Risk of Ruin spreadsheet in the description, and be sure to like, comment, and subscribe.